Joy Buolamwini is the founder of the Algorithmic Justice League. I went to Cambridge, Massachusetts recently to talk with her at the Media Lab at MIT. It seems to me that facial recognition is more ensconced in our day-to-day lives and not less ensconced.
So we've certainly seen an increase in the use of facial recognition technologies, but we've also seen major companies back away. So for example, IBM, Amazon, and Microsoft, they have stepped away from the technology in some capacity. And Facebook also did what I call a face purge, where they deleted the face prints of many users. And at the same time, we've also seen increase in use in some cases, such as we've seen with the IRS adopting ID.me for access to certain services. So it's been a combination. It's an ongoing dance right now.
You called it the coded gaze when we spoke the last time. Refresh for everybody some of the issues around AI. Because listen, nowadays we use our faces to open our phones. And I think people are getting very used to the idea of, sure, use your face to access information. Why not?
Yes, so the notion of the coded gaze is really about power and who has the power to shape the preferences, the priorities of the technologies that we create, and also some of the prejudices as well. And so to your point, when it becomes normalized, right, that the face is an access code, you can trade convenience, right, for some really insidious things that could be happening. So I do think we definitely have to think about the types of technologies we're using and whether it's what we want in society and the use case. So it's one thing to unlock your phone that you choose to do. It's another thing if the government requires you to submit your face to have access to basic services.
So what's the risk there? How often does AI get it wrong, and who do they get it wrong for?
Well, it really depends on the system that you're looking at. In 2019, for example, the government agency, National Institute for Standards and Technology, looked at this question when it came to facial recognition algorithms. What they found was that for African American faces and also Asian faces, as compared to Caucasian faces, the differences were 10 to 100 times. Wow. When it came to false positives, depending on the algorithm you were looking at.
Is the goal ultimately, let's make facial recognition perfect. Let's make it flawless.
So even if we had flawless facial recognition, right now you could be tracked everywhere you go where your face is visible, unknown to you. We really have to think, what does it look like when there's this mass surveillance capability in place? So perfect facial recognition can still be abused. What is oftentimes sold in terms of how it's marketed is this is going to increase efficiency, right? Or this is going to reduce fraud, reduce crime. And so legitimate concerns that enable you to then market a very dangerous technology. So my main focus is, how do we stop the harmful use of facial recognition technologies? The face doesn't become the final frontier for privacy.
Dr. Joy Buolamwini, nice to see you. Thank you for talking with me.
Thank you.